Guess where I am? I am at my debris village. Yeah, two nights, finally. I'm gonna enjoy this. We're there, I'll just turn you around.
There we go.
You can fit in now.
That's the shelter I'm sleeping in tonight.
This is its twin brother that I will be. I've got my like food table, food preparation, ovens, another little raised bed in there.
Also, the back's kind of took a little bit of wind damage, but I can fix that. This lean-to that I started to take down last time I was here was. It's letting the wind blow right into my camp, so I need to sort some out in this area, hopefully tonight.
I'm gonna get my little bed in there. As you can see, that teepee is getting totally changed because it's no longer adequate.
I got all my kit there. My food bag's quite full, also. So yeah. Looking forward to the trip. Well, looking forward to being here. Love it. Can't wait to chill. Gonna get my bed sorted out. I've already had my fire because I've had a coffee with Gary. Brought me.
Doing awesome, stripping down one side of this village. So I've just got all this to strip down, these cross beams, then all of this, and then that all the way. That sun's destroying my shot. Fire's just smoking away slowly.
There's my shadow. Let's see all the wood that I've just pulled out of this one wall. Excessive amounts. And all that pine piled up there and there. This has still got to come down.
So that's getting shifted into an airframe properly
and put over there, which you can't really see because the sun's destroying everything. Three shelters a bit of sleeping areas, and then I can build a working area over here. So yeah, it's going to be a little bit bigger than it was, but it'll be good, and I get the joy of building it. Got a nice big roll of string there too, saving it. Yeah, the reason why I'm moving that is because the wind blows directly from in that side, and it just blows either the smoke or the rain right into the teepee.
Because it's angled, there's the problem. It's taking a lot of the teepee. The rain can sometimes go right to the back of it, so that's not really a usable shelter anymore.
Good to start with, but again, with moss it degrades and falls through over time. It's been a year like since that's been standing, so it's done well. I do love these ones. Look at that. All that massive mound of moss. There's like a whole two shelters worth, I'd say. Loads of it. Got that frame down. All the wood for that's here, as you can see. I'm now surrounded by this pile, pine from here to here, then this pile, and then random pine everywhere else. I'm left with my two best shelters standing so far. Matter of fact, looking at them, I still have some work to do on the sides and the back of that one, because the wind seems to have caught it. Hand above it to stop the sunlight glaring at you. So what I've done is I've changed my mind again, and I am going to keep a lean-to just to separate these two shelters. So I've put it's a bit smaller than the first one, but it's looking good. Sorry about the wind. All the sun's playing hell. Hopefully it'll go down soon. So I'll get a raised bed in there, along there, and hopefully, because the wind hits the back of it, I'll be fine in there. Close to the fire, a little bit smaller, not as tall. Quite nice. And then I'm going to move this shelter and tidy that up and redo that at the other side of the thing, so that it loops out that way. Fire's just two logs that I chucked down, pulled a cross beam down and just chucked it on the ground. It broke into four. So it's
firewood. Keep my fire going while I'm working away.
Yeah, I'm gonna get this pined, which I have an excessive amount, and then I'm gonna moss it with all this moss here, just because we should have a moss shelter. Hopefully the way it's set and the rain won't get in at the bed that I'm gonna build in it.
And that's the back of my new lean-to. Pretty much joins right onto that cabin at the side.
Awesome. Looks nice inside too, and it stopped the wind from hitting the fire.
To the side of the lean-to is I've just basically logged it up and then put loads of pine and used these two main big pegs
to hold all the logs in place. Now I'm just going to go through and fill the little tiny gaps with moss. That'd be sweet. And that's that shelter finished. All tidy and tight little shelter. Get a bed in there. Little table area. That's next to the canteen. Sun's very much going down very soon. Loving all these moss walls, like. Yeah, that's car traffic you can hear in the distance.
Fortunately, it's the only downside of camping on this area.
You know, the fact that we can build whatever we want outweighs the little sound of the traffic in the distance. Sun's gone down past the brow now. Can see a bit better.
Fire's raging.
Love it. This one to deal with still, and I've got so much materials, so I'm just clearing the space for something here. So it got really dark really fast, so oh wait, there we go. So yeah, I've donned all my lights. That lean-to is taking the heat awesomely. Absolutely think it's brilliant. Just the especially the walls along the side here go right up. Then that goes onto the first shelter there, and then my shelter that is a complete mess just because I haven't really set up in there yet. Piles of moss and pine and debris and all sorts. This is a new shelter I'm building. It's pretty much identical to the teepee that was behind us, but I've walled the back, made it more square inside, and I'm going to tidy off all these little bits on the top so it'll level, and then I'm going to tarp the whole thing pretty much to this back wall here. With the wall, you can see I just basically, those two diagonal beams there,
I basically banged into the ground a foot and then bent them onto there to support the wall,
and then there's another one banged in there to push the wall back, so once the whole thing's together it'll crush it in and make it a solid packed wall, which is what we like. Yeah, it's looking damn good. So I've tidied up the top, it's all pretty fine now. I'm gonna get the tarp on top, and then I think it's time to stop for something to eat, because I haven't eaten since I got here. I'm getting hungry and my fire's good, so might as well make the most of it. Aye. I have the oven on over there, and here I have my chicken stuffed with sedge and onion stuffing. Just gonna bang that in the oven and get back to building, and just keep on adding wood to it. Keep on checking it. A whole new other new shelter. I've got like 4 foot of it left, like 4 foot square left of moss, and then it's done. It looks epic and grand at the same time. Way better than the other one. Right, chicken. I'm not going to wrap that in tinfoil yet. I'm going to brown it off first and then tinfoil it, and then just turn up the heat to like 24 logs or something like that. That's the chicken in the oven. It's going to heat up nicely, tinfoil lid. Sweet as. We just started to pile up more in the fire. I've actually done a wood run for the first time today. Chicken's nowhere near cooked, so there's no point in checking on it yet. It's been a low heat for like 5 minutes. fire is most definitely on.
Yeah, just banged up that heat a bit.
Some heat into that chicken. Good. It's looking good. You just see it boiling away in there. Oh, cannot wait, it smells awesome. That's my potatoes, bit of mint and butter in there, salt and pepper, my carrots, just water in there. Chicken it is. Oh. Yorkshire puddings. The roast chicken. It's ready. Potatoes and carrots are ready. Yorkshire's are done too. Just while we're going now, I'm just put a chocolate brownie pie in the oven. Compliments of Tesco's, it's raw brownie mix, I've just got to cook it. So yeah, that's going in the oven now. And this is where I'm starting. That chicken is just amazing. And then I've got my stuff in, my potatoes, my carrots, my Yorkshires. Loving it. Watching that pie very closely. Pie is done. Oh. Awesome. It's been at a tilt. So it's kind of raised to one side. Wind's picking up a lot. Oh. The ice on the wood. It's pretty much everywhere. Just the wind chill's diabolical. I'm back inside. Look at that. That is intense. Fire's raring now. It's getting warm in the shelter. I'm still eating my pie. It's taking a while. Chilling here on my bed. Doesn't get much better than this. Well guys, that's me all tucked in. Catch you in a few hours. Everything's frozen. It's that teepee I built last night. It's like frozen solid already. two-propeller helicopter, that. I think that's called a Chinook or somewhere. Maybe. I'm not 100%. I'll probably be corrected on that. So the teepee I did last night, it's totally finished. A little frozen table on the side of it. Just a lot of frost on that. I can't believe it's like a minute last night and it's frosted already. And it's mossed all the way around. Everything. Totally mossed. But it's tarped underneath that moss too, so it'll be even better. Need to sort in a little windbreak between there too. That's seems to give us a bit of a draft through there. And inside, I've done it long enough so you can get the bed this way. So you've got all this space, and a little hole there, right there. And the tarp rolled up because of the wind, probably, when I were doing it last night. But aye, spot on. Coffee time. Even the floor's frozen.
It's about here last night, the frost.
Like only one shy of that shoulder. So I got recommended this book and I bought it. Just to advance my shelter building skills, if that's possible. Always possible. So yeah, I was looking through it. And there's a lot of good shelters in it, but if you look at that there,
does that look like a shelter?
Easy shelter build. Mark from Scouting Free pointed out that that is clearly not a shelter build. That is easy. It would take a few days though. But yeah, then I was like looking through and a lot of good shelters in it. Mostly tarp shelters and teepees and then airframes and stuff like that. But anyways, I was just going through, having a read of it and all that, and then all of a sudden I came across the shelter that we're actually sleeping in, that I just like kind of made up as I went along. But yeah, turns out it's missed it, and I can't find it when I need it. I should have marked it out. I'll bring you back when I found it.
There,
that is like, exactly how the shelter. Pretty much the same way I built it too, apart from I built
walls up here and up here and then up the back.
And then I made the back higher so I could support this cross beam. And then I just put that one single post in, which is there at the front. And then I did do the one cross beam right across the centre. And then I put loads of ribs on here, and then tarped it, and then put some moss on top of it. Could do gutters if I had like bamboo. Or like a normal log, but I could half it and then like carve out the middle so it's like bamboo. But that would take hours. And the slanting roof kind of covers the whole rain thing anyway. And this one here is sort of like the raised temple one I had, the two-story one. With the beams, and then the cross beams. And then I had the floor, and then I basically put a teepee on the outside of it. So I got myself a little crate. More bed, my lean-to. That'll do for now. But I'm under strong debate whether to kind of get rid of these and just make a crate
shelter away from the village. Because I've never made a crate shelter before, and I think that'd be quite cool.
But that's for another time. Do for now. Right, bacon time for breakfast.
I've also been stocking up wood there. Just piling up, tidying around.
Still frost on
the shelter that I built last night.
That's definitely bacon time. And I've got the hot water on there for some porridge. So I'm starving. Got muffins, so I'm having bacon muffins.
McDonald's style.
Colouring my bacon. Mouth watering. Muffins are on. I'll cut them in half in a second once I've heated through a bit more. There's my bacon muffins. Waiting for my porridge to, just waiting for this water to boil, won't be long. Now it's about lunchtime, second day. I've started bringing in these long logs from away over the other side. It's taking a trek. I brought two, one at a time, and then two once, so yeah, mission. Especially over this sort of ground where it's just debris everywhere.
Just kept my fire going with just little twigs that I've been knocking around. Also decided that this is going to be my new firewood pile up this wall.
Yep. So these logs are, I think, I want a good bench in there instead of the crates. Just because I don't really want the crates in my debris village too much. If you know what I mean, kind of looks out of place. I did it, and I'd do it again. Oh, it's actually the first time I've been warm all day. The shelters, like around here on the outside of the village, they still haven't defrosted. Still, like, fine. Ice particles on it. Yeah, loving the tables. Can never have enough camp tables. I've still got to tidy that one up there, as in take the tops off the four corners and the sides and all that. Bench is spot on. Be sweet once it dries out a bit more. So a nice hot beverage.
Crate's burning amazingly. I'm gonna get close and
get my Gore-Tex warmed up. tell you, nothing burns hotter than a crate. The heat is immense. Warm right through to my marrow. That's the sun starting to go down. That pallet is sparking. Put some logs on top of it to calm it down. Well, that's a fire that keeps the frost away.
That's just a bit of pallet I've still put there for later. I'll save that for bedtime.
So I think it's tea time. Yep. I'm pretty much done building for tonight. It's chilling time. And I'm going to have bangers and mash and gravy. I've got some Yorkshire puddings left over from last night. Potatoes have been on for about 5 minutes now. Not long. I'm going to get a grill on for the sausages and a pan on for my gravy. I'm excited about this. I love mashed potatoes and sausages. Simple things. See, took my eye off the ball for a second about my sausages. Or just some of them anyway. It's okay, I'm just going to keep on telling. I've lost my tongs. It's so irritating when you can't find something that you want. I lost my saw for like 2 hours today too, and it was on the floor. I need to learn not to leave stuff lying around all the time. Sausages are doing grand. Epic, sorry. Gravy pots on there, mashed potatoes in there, not mashed yet. Sausages are burning again, I've got to go. So sure, I dropped grease on that and it's instantly dried. Yeah, I'm wrapping my sausages in tin foil just to finish them off in the fire while I do my gravy and my mash. I do have to admit that I am totally addicted to Yorkshire puddings. Never go. Got the gravy, I've got plenty of sausage left too.
Like finally after a whole night and 2 days, I've sorted out my sleeping area. Tidy. Got me oven on.
Just the fire away back from it at now. Just because I want it to go slowly. Nice and pie. That is my last bit of crate too. Then I'm on logs. Right. Apple pie is about ready. Oh, look at that. I'll put the custard on. Forward to eating this. Custard's on. Steam pockets coming out of it. Yeah, they are. I'm going to play up because my mouth's watering. We've raised the fire, pushed it out and took the oven off too. Got hot water on the go for a hot chocolate before bed. A couple of logs there too to put on shortly. I'm going to sit and chill and eat my apple pie and custard. It's brilliant. Everything I dreamed it was going to be. That's me in my sleeping bag now. Chilling, watching the fire. We'll see y'all in the morning.
Morning. Slept real good.
My fire was totally out and dead this morning. And I had absolutely nothing to light it with. No fire kit or no, so I was like peeling bits of bark off my bench.
Just to get like a bit going. Finally, after a certain amount of irritation, but I got it going.
I just want a coffee before I go. Just got my sleeping bag to pack up. And then my sheet. It's all good.
I'm in the midst of burning my last crate. This early morning, things tidied up in there pretty much. Just got my sleeping bag and my roll mat and that to go.
Got my chest bag on there with some pots I'm taking home. And my rucksack's down here. See, that frost has got thicker. Still some work to do on the back wall of that.
Next time I'm here, and this bottom corner to fill in, and maybe sort out something here again, because that's a little bit inadequate.
I was getting a draft in my back last night. Love the bench.
Be nice in some of that.
Up slowly. Beautiful day, but the wind again is chilly.
Well, guys, that's me all packed up, chest bags on. Managed to get a load of birch bark. I know Adam left us some.
Gets everything tidied up. Awesome. Plodding on.
We'll catch you all again very soon.
You know I can't resist.
Yay!
See, that bit was more rewarding. Crunchier the better, I say. Such a child.